Hello, this is Boyan. Today we will talk about opening and closing books, periods, in a Sage Intacct. With a flexible period closing and opening design, Sage Intacct can easily adapt to your particular business needs and practices. Every company has a different requirement when it comes to month closing, and Sage Intacct should be able to address those requirements. Closing periods process is available for following applications in Sage Intacct: GL, accounts payable, accounts receivable, time expenses, and cash management. Closing periods is a regular part of the month-end process and prevents users from posting transactions to the wrong period. After books are closed, you cannot post transactions in any application for any date older than the month-end date of the period selected for closing. It is important to remember that Intacct closes books always at the last day of the month in which reporting period ends. Even if you're using custom periods, closing a book always is done at the month end. For example, if you sell a custom reporting period that ends at April 25th, the books will close to April 30th, regardless. When closing a books, you can start closing periods starting from subledgers and work its way to a GL, or if you were to close periods from a GL, it will close books for all subledgers. So if you start from accounts payable, you would go to all subledger, click on close, select entity or group for which you're closing period, select your ending period to be closed. So once you select period that you're closing, all periods prior to that will be closed. So if I was to select month ended August 2023, my currently open periods for July and June will get closed as well. So let's pick July. Once you click on close, accounts payable subledger will close period. Similar process exists in accounts receivable. So if you go receivables, subledger close, we can select the period that we'd like to close. So let's not do that. We close accounts payable, but we're currently leaving accounts receivable, subledger, cash management, time and expenses in the period of June. What we can do instead, we can go to the GL, all books, select close option, and select period August 23. And we can leave entity or entity group blank, which means that all subledgers for all entities, you'll have their month closed up to August 23rd. Let's click on close books. Let's close the screen and let's go back to accounts payable and check available months. So if you click on the close process in accounts payable, we'll see that all periods up to September have been closed. So basically, closing process from the GL impacts all subledgers in all entities should we leave entity or entity group drop-down list blank. Once periods are closed, users cannot post entries to any dates older than last day of the period that has been closed. If adjusting entries need to be made, adjusting entries can be made through the GL, journal entries, adjusting entries. This particular item on a menu is created and meant for making entries, adjusting entries to the periods that have been closed. It's subject to user permission, so not every user would have access to GL adjusting entries. There's also a special case available for general ledger, and it's subject to specific settings in a GL. So let's first turn that settings on, and you'll see how it looks like. So setting I'm referring to, it's called locking periods. So if we uncheck option to lock statutory reporting periods in a GL, we will not have an option to run process of locking period in a GL. Difference between closing and locking periods is that adjusting entries in GL are available for closed periods. However, once periods are locked, adjusting entries cannot be made. Periods can be locked or unlocked, and again, subject to different level of permissions. So if you turn that feature back on under configuration, we look for option that's enabling closed statutory periods to be locked. you'll see that we're going to get another option available in a GL where we can now lock close periods. So first prerequisite is for period to be closed. Once it's closed, it can be locked, in which case no adjusting entries can be made unless period is unlocked. If you look this in the reverse order, if you're looking at reopening periods or reopening books, we can start the process from a GL. So if you go to the GL, all tabs, books, and then click on open, when we perform action in this order, we have now option to select a period to be open. So let's say we're going to open period ended June 2023. And now we have option again to select particular entity or entity groups or leave it blank. But now in case of opening periods, we have an option to select which subledger we would like to open. So this would be a case where there's a set of, let's say, accounts payable bills that came to the office too late, month end has been already closed. So you can use this option here to open a GL and open corresponding subledger. Click on open books in all entities, and now system will reopen period of June in a GL and accounts payable subledger for all entities, because I'm running this from the top level and I left my entity or entity group field blank. When it comes to closing fiscal year end, you may have noticed that Sage Intacct does not have a specific item function that executes year-end closing. General ledger closing for the year is essentially the same process as closing for the period, any other period. Prerequisites are, so for the fiscal years that match calendar year, reporting periods are already created. If your fiscal year end does not match calendar year, you would have to create reporting periods that match your fiscal year end. Creating a reporting period is done under GL, setup, more, and then reporting periods. So for example, if your fiscal year end is March 31st, you would create a period that ends 23, with the March 31st being the last period in that reporting period. Once those reporting periods are defined, you'll be able to run period closing where March 31st would be your year-end closing process, just by virtue of being the last month in your fiscal year. So technique of closing a fiscal year, again, is the same as closing the periods. You would go to the GL, books, close, run a closing of the period that's the last month in your fiscal year end, and that's it. So this was a quick overview of Sage Intacct's opening or closing periods. Thank you for watching.